Hey guys, what's going on? I am Hiroshi from WebStylePress.com. Welcome to another video. If this is your first time here, I share tutorials at this channel that can boost up your software engineering skills. So if you want to learn and grow in this area, join this channel by hitting subscribe button and bell icon. In this video, I am going to show you how destructuring works. Destructuring has got many other use cases, but one of its use case is you can avoid using this dot state again and again in class-based components. Each time you have to use a property name from state, you use this dot state dot property name. You can avoid it by using destructuring. Let's start. So this is a class-based component. Class extends component, constructor props, super props, and this is our state. So let's say I've got few properties inside this state. num1, num2, and here is num3. And I want to use these inside this component. So how will I use these? What I will do, let's use a button. And typically you use it like this. This dot state dot num1 to access this value from this property in this state. This dot state dot num1, and then num2 and num3. So we have got these values inside these buttons here, but our goal is to avoid this dot state, writing this dot state again and again. So here is how you will destructure this state. Inside the render, you will use a const and you will use this dot state. And for that const, you will use names of all of these properties. And then you will just remove this dot state from these property names. So it gives me an error: invalid attempt to destructure non-iterable instance. So the problem seems to be here. These will be the curly brackets here. And it will work now. So this is how destructuring works. And in this way, you can avoid typing this dot state each time. Also, you can avoid typing props dot property name. And instead, you can use just property name. Let me show you how. Let's say you have got another component here. Inside the source, let's say user.js. This is another component. So react function component. So this is my component, and here I want to just display a name, props dot name, and here you use the props, right? So let's call this component here. Import user from user, and let's take a look at the user. I was doing again that mistake. The first letter of component should be capital. Let's use this user, and break user, and I want to pass a value here, name, I want to pass some name here. Let's define the name here. It's a string, and name, and I'll pass the name here. So the name is being displayed here. If I do not destructure it here, I will have to use here like this dot state dot name, then it will work. Or if I do not want to use this dot state, I will have to use name here. I will have to destructure it, and then I will use just this name. And now here you are using this props, and then you are extracting the value of name from the props, right? You can just directly destructure it right here, and then you don't have to use props here. It will work. And you are doing destructuring right here in this case. Otherwise, if you don't use it like this, you will have to call props here, and then you will have to use props.name here. See, if you console props, it will show you the value inside these props. And let's say you are passing another value here, num1 and number2. And now this object. Now I'm not calling these values, but from the props I am getting these values inside this component: name, number 2, 1 and 2. Okay, so if you want to destructure all of these here, but first of all let's see props dot name. See, I can see the only the value of the property. I will delete it from here, and now I can destructure multiple values from here. Number 2, num1, num2, basically num1, num2, and now I will use only name here that I have destructured here, and I can see this, and then here num1, num2. Nope, again mistake. Number and number two. I was right the first time. Number two. So these are our three values. So basically, I'm calling these values from these. This name contains this value, and this number contains value of num1. So I will call these in the next component. I will destructure it. This contains the value, right? Number and number two contains values. Number and number two contains values. Num1, num2 values. So I will destructure these, and then I will use these without prop start. So it will give me the values. So this is destructuring for you guys. Very simple. So this one with curly braces. Here you can destructure this stuff that is here in this state, and if you are passing the values in the other component, then you can destructure these and use these without prop start something. That's it, guys. It was destructuring in reactjs for you. I hope you like this video. If I missed anything or you have something to add, you can comment down below. Ask questions related to this topic. If you haven't already subscribe to the channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.